Hello and welcome to another video by AddA. AddA is a community of sales professionals. It's a space for us to meet, share, learn and grow. We as salespeople are part of many stories and at times we may not even realize it. As we go about making calls from one prospect to another, we become part of people's lives. To most, we won't even matter, but some remember. The question is, at the end of the day, when the individual stories are told, how would we like to be portrayed? It certainly depends on us. Bill Porter, an Oregon door-to-door salesman who plied his trade for decades despite having severe cerebral palsy. The story of Bill Porter was told because of his interactions with the customer. The impression he left on one person was so strong that it made it into a newspaper many years later. If this interaction had not made an impression, the world would have never heard of Bill Porter, and he would have gone down in history as any number of nameless door-to-door salespeople who have pounded the sidewalks for decades.
Now listen. It takes people a wee bit longer to warm up to you. Just be patient. Patient and persistent. You're gonna be great.
In those cases, they're heavy. Hell, a lot of the guys, they're carrying two cases with them. Now, I admire your determination, but then the walking. You understand what I'm getting at. I don't see any way this can work. I'm sorry. Thanks for coming in.
Mr. Hernandez, give me your worst route. Give me the area nobody wants. What have you got to lose? If I can sell it, you're a hero.
Mr. Porter, let's be honest. This is a physically demanding job, and you're, well, crippled. And I don't see how... Ow. What?
People say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day
nervous?
Yeah.
Oh, nuts. I was going to make you a lunch.
No.
Oh. Well, good for me. I guess I'm a little nervous, too.
Nervous, you are.
Well, what are you waiting for? Them to come to the car? Go sell some soap.
How did this happen? Shortly after securing his job, or rather persisting to get a job, Bill calls on one of the houses in his territory. The child is frightened, as the mother complains to the company.
Don't get ready to go. Don't let the dog.
My name is Bill Porter. And I was...
Oh, Pina, would you shut the hell up? Go on. Now get back there. Sit. Oh, Sherry, would you get your damn dog? Swear to God. What?
My name is Bill Porter. And I was wondering if I could take a moment of your time to show you some of the many fine Watkins products.
Joey, I told you to put your pants on.
Hey,
I once had a fish named Joey.
Oh, shoot! Oh, grab him, would you grab him? Sherry, your damn dog got out, damn it!
I'm in the bathroom!
Peanut, come here!
The boss threatens to fire him. Bill comes up with a novel idea of using a toy to entertain and befriend the child. Not only does he befriend the child, but he also enters the house and makes himself a new customer.
I can see the tremendous effort you're putting into this. I know it can't be easy, but you're not even close.
It's only been 4 days.
I understand, but the average... You're gonna have to hit at least...
I'm building. It takes time.
I know that, but...
Just give me till the end of the month.
We had a complaint from a woman on Chestnut Street. She said you scared her little boy. You can see my problem.
Hey, my name is Lyle. You can call me Lyle or Glyle or Mr. Pyle, but whatever you do, don't smile. You better not smile.
Who is it, Joey?
Mr. Pyle.
Huh?
Mr. Pyle.
What the hell? Come on in.
This is really a lovely home.
The same child returns a few years later to write his story.
Oh, hey. Hi.
Oh.
Sorry. I didn't know which apartment. You're Bill Porter, right?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Joey Wallace, Portland Daily News.
Hi.
Sorry, I scared you there. Guess we're even.
How do you mean?
Well, you scared me when I was a little kid, remember? You had that hand puppet, Kyle Pyle.
Wallace, 362 Chestnut.
You've got an amazing memory. It's very impressive. May I?
No, I have to go.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll get right to the point then. I want to write a story about a door-to-door salesman. Last of a dying, lost of a tradition.
No.
Well, it wouldn't necessarily have to be just about you.
Thank you, but no.
Take my card then. You change your mind. I guess this is where I'm supposed to plant my foot, try to keep you from closing the door on me.
No, don't do that. That never works.
That's the kind of thing I thought we could talk about.
The short clip shares the true value of the salesperson in this community.
I never really took notice until he wasn't there anymore. This odd man with the funny walk and the briefcase and his hat set just so. One day he just stopped coming.
Damn chilblains are killing me. Damn, it's so dry. Tried everything.
He was a thread. An invisible thread in our neighborhood. Which tied us together. Bringing us news. Who died? Who moved away? Who just got married? He's a door-to-door salesman for the Watkins Company, who many considered unemployable.
In the modern context, when transactions are made over phone, online tools, and emails, one could claim that the opportunity to build a strong personal bond with the customer does not exist. But that is not entirely true. To be part of a story, perhaps not a great story, but a story nevertheless, a single interaction can leave an impression for a lifetime. At the end of the day, we are but a collection of our stories. So how many stories are you making today? And how are you starring in them? Thank you for watching the video. If you find it of value, please like and share. If you'd like to be notified of the latest content, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Have a great day. Happy hunting.